There's something that's poetic about this. Now, I don't celebrate the injury to Daniel Jones by any stretch, and I think that this could end up helping Jones as well. He's lost 8 games in a row.
Right.
And, you know, the bottom line is you've got a situation where I think that last year when Sam Darnold went down, I think that helped him. He came back as a better quarterback. It gives you a chance to reset. But it's so funny because there's an outside chance that both Gettleman and Shermer's jobs are on the line. And the guy who, in my opinion, now Don disagrees with me, I'm not sure if Peter does, the guy they disrespected by pulling the plug on him so early, he now could save their job and throw a monkey wrench in the plans of the Giants. Let's say there's some Eli magic that's still there, and he can win 3 of the next 4 games. All of a sudden, they don't get Chase Young.
You know what's interesting, though, Michael? I understand what you're saying, but couldn't Eli going out there and winning games actually hurt Shermer?
No.
Why?
Because I think they're gonna need wins to help Shermer out.
But then you could turn it around and say, well, if you kept Eli in, maybe they would have won some games when it actually meant something. Like, if Eli goes out there, and I don't think it's going to happen, but Philadelphia's struggling, and they got Philadelphia twice. They got a game coming up against Miami.
Washington.
What if Eli goes out there and it's 4-1?
No, they only have 4 games left.
I mean, for the 3-1, right?
Well, they give an extra game because he goes 4-0 in the first 4.
Let's say they go 3-1.
Right.
And they beat Philadelphia on Monday Night Football. That you don't think there's going to be a narrative of, wait a minute, you pulled Jones because you thought that Eli was shot, and here he is awful team winning games.
I'll flip that narrative.
All right.
He's going to be able to say, we had to get Jones in there to prepare for the future. We knew that Eli was better. That's what he's going to say.
Well, so that's what I believe.
It shows you that this team would have a better record if Eli had started the whole year, but for the future, they might not be set up for it.
And that's what I really believe. I don't think Eli was disrespected. I think it was, we're 0-2, we're not going anywhere. Let's go to our quarterback so we can hit the ground running in 2020. That's what I believe. We agree to disagree on that. But I don't know what they're going to get out of Eli. He hasn't played since September. The team is god-awful. This could be like a great story where he goes out and he wins a couple of games and just gets a nice little flavor in his mouth to end his career, because you always kind of remember the last you saw, right? This could be like a nice story. He goes out there, he wins a couple of games, beats the Eagles on Monday Night Football. It's a nice way to go out, bow out. But it also could be a unmitigated disaster where they lose all 4 games. He's god-awful. Mm-hmm. Maybe even gets hurt, God forbid, because let's face it, this offensive line hasn't been great. This offense has not been great. It can go the other way, too, where it just accentuates what's really been a lousy few years for Eli. So I'm hoping, because I'm an Eli guy, that he goes out there and he does well and you get a nice little taste in your mouth going into the great beyond. But I'm not really sure about that. Well, I don't know what they're going to do. This team isn't good.
There's a couple of things that could happen, though. Now, number one, Eli Manning has never said that this is the last year of his career.
But it's going to be his last year in New York.
Well, yeah, but if now this could be a 4-game tryout if Jones is out that long.
Yeah.
It could be a 4-game tryout for people to say, well, this guy could play. Now, you're right. The offensive line has been a sieve, so that doesn't play well into Eli's hands. But, you know, this guy knows how to win. I think you bring up a good point. He has not played since September. So what exactly is he going to bring to the table? Is he in great game shape? I'm sure he's got pride and has kept himself into shape. But, you know, we're going to see. But this guy, if he goes 3-1, I truly believe he at least saves Shermer's job.
I